of the Caribbean to the jungles of South America to the inner cities of North America across the oceans to Europe and Africa and over into Asia.
Of a child more innocent than gold. All right, all praise and glory to the Most High today in Yeshua HaMashiach. I am coming to you all today. Linus on the Rise, and I played that song because this is what this show is going to be about today. It's going to be about the children, and they say, the song, you know, in the lyrics, he says, you know, the best time to train a child is when a child is young, when it's innocent and pure, right? That's how children are. I think many of us have forgotten that. We have really actually, we forget children are innocent and they are pure. They have no understanding of what goes on around them. The adults, the mothers, the fathers who bring these children in the world are responsible for them. They are held accountable. Anyways, all glory again to my Father. All glory to Yahushua HaMashiach, and all glory to the Ruach HaKodesh. And I bless the angels, right, who are here by our side. This show, this segment, really got initiated because I had a dialogue with one of a subscriber a while back. She goes by the name of Auntie Sheeple Pleaser Mitchell. All right, I'm sure some of you all probably have heard about her. She gives out a lot of truths, and she got about almost 23,000 subscribers. 23,000 subscribers she has. And how this got started, this dialogue with me and her, is about education and her son. She was having problems in her son's school, and I made some comments about the school, and I made her aware. I sent her a lengthy comment explaining to her about the breakdown of the educational system, the name of the person who invented it. Because my understanding is that she is she does research, and she's always putting out truth, and she's always giving the public, she spent a lot of time giving the public a lot of truth. But I'm starting to believe maybe it's just, and I don't know if this is a form of income for her. I don't know what's going on, because I'm a little confused. Because if you're someone that you knows the truth, and you're not supposed to, you identifying yourself maybe as not a sheeple, but maybe she is a part of the sheeple, because, a lot of things that she's doing is not making sense to me based on some dialogue. And this is in regards to her son in Boston, the public education system, knowing that this is the system. She's had some problems with the teacher, a certain teacher with her son, and we know, most of us who are in the truth, we know what this education system is about now, okay? And those of you all that who are either still sleeping, you all are still believing, you all are still really believing that this education system, it is educating your children. That's the atrocity. So in a way, this show is dedicated to the children. I'm dedicating this show to the children. I'm going to send this segment to this anti-sheeple Mitchell, because she needs, and I'm going to play a segment that she herself had put out to the public. All right? So, we have people that who will say that in the truth, but they don't live by the truth that they preach, that they present to the public. They present all this knowledge, but the knowledge that they present, they themselves don't take heed to it. I mean, she gives all these excuses under the sun of why she keeps her child in this evil educational system, knowing what this thing is about now, knowing what this beast and what this machinery is really about and the whole purpose of it. And I'm going to give you all a thorough breakdown about that today. I took the time to do some research. It didn't take much, because I've already had plans to do this. And it's a good thing when you put stuff aside, and then when the time comes, you don't really have to do as much work. But I did get a little some other stuff from here and there. And I have quite a bit stuff that I had put aside. And I didn't even need to go through all of them, okay? I mean, it just doesn't make sense. You just like to have backup and resources available to always confirm what we already know is fact. Okay, let me say my psalm. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High should abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of Yahuwah, He is my refuge and my fortress. In Yah will I trust. He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowl and from the deadly pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckle. Thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, nor for the arrow that fly by day, and nor for the deadly pestilence that stalketh in the darkness, or the destruction that wastes at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thy eyes should thou behold and see the reward of the wicked, because thou wast made Yahuwah, which is my refuge, the Most High, thy habitation. There no evil shall befall thee, neither no plague come near thy dwelling, but he shall give his angels charge of thee to keep thee in all thy ways. And they shall bear thee up in their hands, lest you dash your foot against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and the adder, the young lion and serpent. Thou shalt trample on the feet. Because he cleaves to me in love, I will protect him. Because he knows my name, I will answer him. When he called to me, I'll answer him. I'll be with him in trouble. I'll deliver him and honor him with long life. I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. Hallelujah. Okay. So, we're going to talk about the educational system that's in the United States of America, and the intent of it, the structure of it, who was who the individual who is the co-founder of it and who founded it and who they consider the they call him the inventor of or one of the founder of the American education system. But he's given most of the notoriety here, so that's why I'm going with him. And his name is John Dewey. All right. Hopefully after Auntie Sheeple Mitchell listened to my segment, she will actually put her son first place and actually forget about her job, forget about whatever her responsibility is, and take her son out of this devil's trap while she has time to do so. And many other parents who listen to this segment, I mean, once I explain to you and give you all of this information, which is available to you yourself, and she's supposed to be a person that knows all about the truth. She puts out, hundreds of videos that she done put out, educating the public, but yet apparently she can't take that same information, you know, and really question, you know, what I need to do with my child, because he's in harm's way. But anyways, let's get into the heart of the discussion here. All right, so this man's name is John Dewey, and he was an American philosopher, psychologist, okay, that's the best I can do, and he was a Georgist, and an educational reformer, whose ideas have been influential in education and social reform. Now, before I go into this, giving you the background of this man and the whole education purpose that he designed and implemented, he also was associated with the Human Manifesto. Many of you all probably don't even know what that is, but I'm going to tell you what that is. Let me say that in Colossians, it says in chapter 2, verse 8, "See to it that no one makes a prey of you by philosophy and empty deceit, according to human tradition, according to the elemental spirit of the universe, and not according to Yahushua HaMashiach, who you may still call Jesus Christ." All right? See to it that no one make a prey. And I think any of you all, you understand what prey means. Prey means, you know, just like when a lion is about to kill for his food, he looks at his prey. And that's what society and these men have made you people, and they still are doing to your children. Your children are prey because you all have allowed them to become subjected to man's philosophy. All right? Let me just start again. He was an American philosopher, psychologist. Thank you, Ruach. Juros, all praise and glory to the Ruach HaKodesh. He was a Georgist and an educational reformer whose ideas have been influential in the education and social reform. All right, so his education purpose was to train students for work by providing the student with a limited set of skills and information to do a particular job. Now remember, I said limited sets of skills. Limited sets of skills. People, please remember that. As Dewey notes, the limited vocational view for many, education's purpose is to train students for work by providing the student with a limited set of skills, once again, and information to do a particular job. As do we know, this limited vocational view is also applied to teacher training schools who attempt to quickly produce proficients. Dewey, 1904. For Dewey, the school and the classroom teacher, as a workforce and a provider of social services, have a unique responsibility to produce psychological and social goods that will lead to both present and future social progress. And now let me explain what they're saying right now. It is the teacher's job to train these students, these potential students, into a workforce, all right, that's provided of social services. Social services, there's different levels in society, as you all know, when it comes to the job, the levels of job. You have the, excuse me, you know, you have the janitorial line of work, the trash, and all of these things are under social services. Social services meet the needs of the higher-ups, the rich, okay? And you're meeting and fulfilling also, supposedly they make you feel like you're serving humanity. But it's all in a disguise, and we're going to talk about it. It has a unique responsibility to produce a psychological and social goods. Now remember psychological. Psychological means that you are there training you, programming you to do a certain particular task. All right, so we're going to just make sure you, I'm hoping you understand what I'm saying, to produce psychological and social goods. They consider people as goods, all right? They didn't say people, they said goods. All right. According to Dewey, the emphasis is placed on producing these attributes in children for use in their contemporary life, because it is impossible to foretell definitely just what civilization will be 20 years from now, absolutely. Especially if you were to train them right. They know that there's a possibility that children could go very potentially right. He's saying it's impossible. It's not impossible. Whatever you put in a child today that is right, that fruit will grow into that purpose if you put in the right seed, plant the right seed in that child. So that's a lie right there. But anyways, let's go on. According to Dewey, the profession of the classroom teacher is to produce the intelligence, skill, and character within each student to that democratic community. The democratic community is composed of citizens who can think, do, and act intelligently and morally. Now you notice here, I want to draw your attention, it says to that democratic community. Already that they're telling you here that it's the teacher's job to train children and give them intelligence and skills and character with each student. That for a democratic community, it shouldn't be for a democratic community, it should be for the world community, right? But it's just geared to a specific political type of philosophy or political thinking, a political mindset. That is what the educational system is constructed to do, all right? And that's just a part of it. I'm just giving you, I'm briefing you all. Is composed of citizens who can think, do, and act intelligently and morally. They say that, but they want you to act under that, within that democratic guideline. All right? As a result of the direct influence teachers have in shaping the mental, moral, and spiritual lives of children during their most formative years. Now, this is a problem I have. Why is teachers have the authority to spiritually shape our children's lives? Are you all even aware that that's going on? Now, let me tell you something. Maybe they may say it's not, and how, because they have excluded, they used to have prayer in school, all of these things are not supposed to be considered now all religion, because you have to be so mindful of all these 101 different religions that they bombard you and confuse you with, right? So, excuse me. So, in them saying that, spiritual lives, but I'm going to tell you why they say spiritual lives, all right? Because actually, when I finish explaining to you, I'm going to let you see that how the whole educational system, it is geared on keeping you confused and uncertain about the reality of the Most High, the God they call God, who lives in heaven. How they use this educational system to minimize his existence and his part as far as being the whole soul creator of this whole world on in its entirety. Okay, so remember it says here, as a result of the direct influence teachers have in shaping the mental, moral, and spiritual lives of children during their most formative years. Dewey holds the profession of teaching in high esteem, often equating its social value to that of the ministry and to parenting. So they're taking the position of ministering to your children and parenting your children, whether you like it or realize it or not. Now let me give you a little background about who this John Dewey is. Now if you think he wasn't a Freemason, trust me, he was. But I'm going to go on and let you know what this man's character was, that who shaped this educational system. You people don't even begin to even know or inquire. I don't know if any of you all probably don't even take the time to examine what they're teaching your children. Okay? And that's why everybody thinks the way they think, act the way they act. All right. As an atheist and a secular humanist in his later life. So this man was an atheist. And you all who know what an atheist is. An atheist is someone who does not believe in God and they don't believe God exists. Also, I mentioned to you all that he was a Georgist. Now, let me tell you what a Georgist is, okay? A Georgist is an economic philosophy. Is an economic philosophy holding that white people should own the value they produce themselves. Economic value derived from land, including natural resources and natural opportunities, should belong equally to all members of society. But, you know, clearly they don't mean that, because if that was the case, it should never say, it is an economic philosophy holding that white people, it specifically says white people. Go on Wikipedia, go Wikipedia.com and put in John Dewey, and when you see next to his name, it says Georgist, click on Georgist, and it will give you the breakdown of what it says. Okay, now whether they either just added it in there, because you know this makes it better for them when people read stuff like this, it's supposed to make them get angry. But I am here not to make you to get angry. I'm here to make you to get wake you up, okay, and get angry and take your children out of these schools, because they're only destroying your children's mind and their spiritual foundation, okay. People should own their value and produce themselves. I don't know what they own and what natural resources these white people come with. Because everything that these white people claim to have, say that they belong and own, they came and they conquered, they killed and stole and took. They ran from the UK to America. And whatever land that they found is what land that they conquered. It's just what you call a conquering and a conquering. Goes on and on. So anyways, I don't know what they're talking about, including natural resources and natural opportunities. Natural opportunities mean in his way probably around slavery time. Whatever a black man had. It has to be. Because they own black people. All right? Secular, what is a secular humanism? Secular humanism is a philosophy of life stance that embraces human reasons, ethics, social justice, and naturalism, while specifically rejecting religious dogma, supernaturalism, pseudoscience, and superstition as the basis of morality and decision making. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, they're identifying the Most High in here, okay? And how they do that, they say supernaturalism. Because when you think about the Most High, we always say it's in the supernatural. Everything when you refer to the Most High and the Father is always the supernatural. And that's your own wicked, sneaky way of letting you know who they're talking about. But I'm not finished yet. He also praises the Soviet Union. All right? All right. John Dewey. He worked on a book with Stephen Rockefeller called Religious Faith and Democratic Humanism. Now, that's why I want to tell you he is associated. He was a part of the one percenter. The powers to be, because if you worked in a book with Rockefeller, you all know already, for those of you who are in the truth and you're fully aware about who the 1%ers are, the powers to be, Rockefeller, the Illuminati, all right, and the bloodline, okay, all these, they're rich, right? Being one of the original 34 signatories of the first Humanist Manifesto in 1933. Look at that number. All right. So you hear my song playing in the background? Yaya is the ruler. Don't let nobody fool you, but they're going to find that out in a minute. Fortunately, they're going to find out the bad and the wrong way. Moving on. All right. This is the evidence. That's why I wanted you all to know. Stephen Rockefeller. We know who Rockefellers are. The central theme of all three manifestos is the elaboration of a philosophy. Here you go again with this philosophy, people. Remember what Colossians says? See to it that no one makes a prey of you by philosophy and empty deceit. I just wanted to reinforce it again. The central theme of all three manifestos in the elaboration of a philosophy and value system, which does not necessarily include beliefs in any personal deity or higher power, although the three differ considerably in their tone, form, and ambition. Each has been signed as it launched by various prominent members of the academia and other who are in general agreement with its principles. All right? So this is, you know, when they say higher power, I don't think we need to get any, I don't think none of you all should be confused of who and what they are referring to when they say they do not believe in any personal deity or higher power. They are outright saying they do not believe in Yahuwah Elohim, Yahushua HaMashiach, who they call and have given everybody and told everybody who is called God. All right. Now the human manifesto, there's three of them. This is the first one says, the first manifesto talk of a new religion. Here we go, the new religion. That means from back then they've been planning this new world order, okay? New religion and refer to humanism as a religious movement to transcend and replace previous religions that were based on allegations of supernatural revelations. People, do you hear what I just said? Since this is how long these people have been planning this, right? So this is a movement that has been in the works. This is who the person who teaches, who created the educational system. All right? So now you know why everybody's so godless and so Yahoo-less. I have to say it like that. A religion movement to transcend and replace previous religions that were based on allegations of supernatural revelation. Supernatural revelation means the Most High. Yahushua HaMashiach. Okay. These are the principles and the foundations of the academic educational systems that black people send their children to. Okay. Now, I have a couple of clips that I am going to bring into here, and I have some other things that I wanted to read to you all in regards to, let me give you some information about anti-sheeple pleasing people, and why we had, what basically kind of triggered this discussion today. Okay, where is it? Here it is. Okay, here's the first one. So, I just gave you all, I just want to tell you a little bit about this interaction, because I am sending this to Auntie Sheba Pisa Mitchell, because she needs to hear. Sometimes people don't really understand the severity of the decisions they're making when it comes to their children. And they don't understand the impact that it really does have on their children, right? Because she, you know, in order for me to get, let me get into this, what she said, what the problem, what started this, okay? I went over John Dewey. I'm not finished with John Dewey. There's some other things I'm going to read to you. And I have a couple of clips I'm going to put in. Actually, one of the clips happens to be a video that Auntie Sheba Pleaser did about herself bringing awareness about what they're bringing into the school system, right? But yet still, she can't find a way to get her children out of this same system that she is so aware of all of the atrocities and the abominable things that they're bringing into the education. If she thinks that if they're doing anything in any state in the educational system, be certain it's going to spread to all of the states. What they do in one state, they're going to do in another, and another, and another, till the whole entire United States is saturated with it, and they're all on the same program. Trust me, once it's been approved, because the Department of Education is the Department of Education, okay, which is supposed to start from the White House, which oversees all of the education that is happening in the United States of America, all right? And if they have approved it, approved certain new type of curriculum to come into the educational system, into the academia world, to be a part of these children's curriculum now, trust me, it is going to come to your school, okay? And you people need to think about this. You need to stop running to these damn jobs. You all put your jobs before your children every single day. And the Most High is going to judge you all for those things. The one you call Jesus. Now, this anti-sheeple pleaser, Miss Mitchell, I got to call her because I had called Alinus Warrior, but I had to take that back because she's not. Because Alinus takes care of her cubs. A real Alinus, she don't play with her children. Not in one iota. A real Linus. That's why I had initially called her that, because she comes off strong like that. You see what I'm saying? And I'm going to give you my little story that has to do with this educational system that concerns my daughter. Okay, and she's been out now, I think it's almost 2 years, praise and thanks to the Most High. Okay, you people give this system all this authority over your lives and over your children's life. That's why the Most High allowed Barack Obama to be the president, because he said you all wanted a president that will encourage homosexuality and all of these perverseness that we are now having to accept and consider normal, which was not at one point, because you all accept it. Okay? So it's the same scenario. Okay, when you have something like that in the government, it's only a matter of time when it's going to trickle down into the educational system, and we are forced to, they're going to force your children to be taught these things. You see? And if you call yourself a believer in the Most High, and a believer in Yahushua, or a believer in Jesus, because she said she doesn't ascribe to no Hebrew Israelites. I hope she remembers those words. Because when the Hebrew Israelites and the black Hebrew Israelites, the father, who is going to be, when we get put back to our rightful royal position, because we are the ones that are going to be in charge, always. It's never going to happen again with the Gentiles. Your time is done. I hope she remembers it, and I hope she changes her mind before the Most High Yahushua comes back. Okay? Because if she considers herself, if she have any heritage and her ancestry that has been slave in this country, trust me on that, love, you are an Israelite. All right? But anyways, I'm going to, and that's because of probably she's been educated in the system. She's suffering from it too as well, whether she wants to understand or not. And I told her just that. But let's get into what I told her. Now, let me tell you what happened. I says, anti-sheeple pleaser Mitchell, I overhear you say you're going to your son's school to handle some business. I thought you were going to do homeschool. I'm not sure how to take you. But now they are going to allow teachers to be armed in school with handguns. Is this enough reason to take your son out of this devil system? You seem to still actually believe they're educating your son. Now people will have to pray their children will not get shot before the second period. You disappoint me. I called you Warrior Linus, but it looks like I might have to take back my opinion of you. You're intelligent, but not for your own life. All right? So here's what she responded to me and says. He has to finish this year. There are only 2 months left in the school year and no availability for the virtual learning schools at that time. Open enrollment just began for that. I can't just remove my children from the school to homeschool them and all the dot, without first having a solid plan to do so. If you don't plan, then you plan to fail. Now let me tell you something right now. She gonna fail either way. You see what I'm saying? Because listen to what she says. Now she still don't even get what all the information I sent to this woman. She probably never followed up on nothing that I sent her. Okay? Because if I'm telling you that your children, your child is, they're only indoctrinating your child. Your children are not learning anything of substantialism. You know what I'm saying? You're not teaching your children in a way to educate them. They're teaching them to dumb them down, to indoctrinate them. So let's get into the rest of what is indoctrination, all right? So let me get into, where is it? Okay, here's, is this the dude? All right, I'm going to give, hold on, let me get this, no, this is not the one. Okay, here's the one. All right. Now, what I want to tell you, before I tell you about indoctrination, I'm going to read you a little research clip that I had gotten from one of my videos that I had copied, downloaded, just doing, keeping research stuff. So here's what it says, all right? And this is how they identify John Dewey, another great influence on how public education would be directed. Was John Dewey, 1859-1952, known as the father of the progressive education movement and a great influence with the powerful National Education Association, NEA. Mr. Dewey's progressive model of active learning, of pragmatism, promoted a revolt against abstract learning and attempted to make education an effective tool for integrating culture and vocation. Dewey was responsible for developing a philosophical approach to education called experimentalism, which saw education as the basis for democracy. Again, that word democracy. His goal was to turn public schools into indoctrination centers. His goal, let me read it again. I want to read that line for you again. His goal was to turn public schools into indoctrination centers to develop a socialized population that could adapt to an egalitarian state operated by the intellectual elite. Now, I hope, let me say it for you all again. And when I say it, then I'm going to break it down for you because this is a very important sentence. His goal was to turn public schools into indoctrination centers to develop a socialized population that could adapt to an egalitarian state operated by intellectual elite. Now let me tell you what indoctrination means. All right? Indoctrination means teaching someone to accept a set of beliefs without questioning them. Indoctrination often refers to religious ideas. When you are talking about religious, an environment that does not let you question or criticize those beliefs. The Latin word teach, doctrinia, is the root of indoctrinate, and originally, that's just what it meant. By the 1830s, it came to mean the act of forcing ideas and opinions on someone who isn't allowed to question them, okay? Teaching someone to accept doctrines uncritically, the types are brainwashing, forcible indoctrination into a new set of attitudes and beliefs, okay? Inculcation, ingraining, instilling, teaching or impressing upon the mind by frequent instructions or repetitions. Instructions, pedigree, teaching, the profession of the teacher. Okay? So, in pretty much being indoctrinated is that you would not know you're being indoctrinated. Many of us didn't know. I didn't know I was being indoctrinated. But you are, okay? Because that's what public schools is designed for. And you all can go on Wikipedia and follow up. Please, always follow up on what I say. All right? Let me finish read the rest of this thing here. Thinking of Dewey was a collective phenomenon. Disavowing the role of the individual mind in achieving technological and social progress. Dewey promoted the group rather than the teacher as the main source of social control in the schools. Here, the key word here is social control. Social control. That's why you all are so controlled. That's why when people try to explain things, the first thing people say, why are you yelling? Lots of you all are controlled, man. Denying the idea of universal principles, natural law, and natural rights. You hear that? Denying the ideas of universal principles, natural law, and natural rights. Dewey emphasized social value and taught that life adjustments is more important than academic skills. So in other words, it's not important for you all to learn. You know what I'm saying? It's more important for them to train you the way they want you to be. You know? It says here, a new public mind is to be created. How? Only by creating tens of millions of individual minds and wielding them into a new social mind. Brainwashing. All stereotypes must be broken up and new climates of opinions form in the neighborhoods of America. And they were planning to do that forming for you, okay? Let me tell you, I want to share. Oh my gosh. The other thing I want to bring into this, and I had actually did a segment on the educational system using, now I know that I found out, you know, David Icke, he has a whole bunch of demons in him, and I always question him, but anyways, they put out the truth. They put out the truth because they're confident, and they're cocky, and they're arrogant, and they don't feel that they have anything to be concerned about at this point, because they figure they have all the money, and nobody can stop them. They have all the power, and they have all the money, and they have the devil on their side. So that's where they feel. But anyways, let me just give you a little breakdown about, I had did some research a while back about the educational system in the Western world. And he identified it really good for me. And I took the opportunity and liberty to write down everything he had to say about it. And I want to share what he said. He said, the brain has two hemispheres. The education system is a system that takes young people from children 4 years old to 17 years old. The education system is really a system. A system is about indoctrination. And with the system, we are using a fraction of our brain. The system do not allow us to use the right side of our brain. And they do that by indoctrinating us into schools, such as elementary, middle, and high school, and into college. And how this works is, it is that they feed you all of this information at the time of being tested or having an exam. You will need to regurgitate all of that information back. So whatever you studied, they pretty much gave you what to study. You have to study it over and over and over until it's in your mind. You have to spit it back out. That's indoctrination. Now, if you respond using your right side of your brain and you gave the answer in a different way, other than the way you studied it or the way they want you to answer it, you are considered a troublemaker. And they call you dumb, or you're not meeting the criteria. Your IQ or whatever your level status of how they grade you. You have to reply with the same answer that they give you to be considered successful and be accepted. Okay, this is the blueprint to how to brainwash and control the masses of people, and getting them to think in the same way and to agree with any given agenda that can be unethical and unmoral. Okay? All right. Now, there was something else I wanted to bring into play here. Let me see. Actually, I think I'm going to tell you about the root of the education of the Priscillian system, okay? And this is how they included this type of experiment onto school and in the education system, okay? And let's see here. I think this is the right one. All right. Okay, let me read this to you. Using the basic philosophy prescribing the duties of the state, combined with John Locke's view, 1690, that children are a blank slate, and lessons from the Rousseau, on how to write on the slate. Priscilla established a three-tier educational system that was considered scientific in nature. Work began in 1807, and the system was in place by 1819. An important component of the Priscillian system was how it defined for the child what was to be learned, what was to be taught, how long to think about it, and when a child was to be allowed to think of something else. This is where the Pavlovian bell ringing each hour of class time comes from in our current school system. Now let me just stop and just to tell you, meant to talk about that really quick. And many of you all, I don't know, you know, if the system has changed any. I'm assuming it hasn't. But if some of you all still have that 6-period, that 7-period classroom, you will hear a ringing, and you go to the next classroom. You don't forget everything what you learned in that last classroom. And it's like it's preparing you to learn for the next classroom. Those ringing a bell is also a psychological training that they have implemented on you. And this is where it comes from. It's called the Pavlovian bell ringing. If you do the research, it explains to you they've done it with a dog. Okay, and then they implement it into the current, you hear what it says, but this is where it comes in our current school system, okay? All right, let me see, there was something else I wanted to mention. All right, let me just mention this before I get into, I'm going to say some scriptures. I want to get into some scriptures, and I'm going to finish. Let you all hear a couple of things that's going on with this educational system, and also using that same anti-sheep pleaser, parents outraged by transgender revealed in kindergarten, right? She's brought this information, and I actually downloaded it because I thought it was very well worthy of keeping. For research purposes, getting this from her. And it's just, you know, it's sad to see that she, as a parent, she can't make a decision that is such a significant decision that affects her own child. She's only focusing on the financial loss and how she has to manipulate that. She's not thinking of the damage that her child has incurred and is incurring. That's the problem, right? So let's talk about this. Here's another little thing I wanted to talk, let you all be aware of, what the educational process is for. The power of the individual large foundation is enormous. Its various forms of patronage carry with them elements of thought control. It exerts immense influence on educator, educational process, and educational institutions. It is capable of invisible coercion. It can materially predetermine the development of social and political concepts, academic opinions, thought, leadership, and public opinion. So pretty much what you're saying is that they used the educational process to create the type of political concept, political thinking, the type of they use the educational process to control how you think politically. All right, this is what this process is all about. All right, it says the power of the individual, large foundation is enormous. Its various forms of patronage carries with them the elements of thought control. It exerts immense influence on the educator, educational process. So however the educational process is structured, it is what shapes it helps shapes the course of this country. And whatever they want you all to do, they funnel it through the educational process. You see what I'm saying? That's how you all are getting indoctrinated. Let me see what this one is. And I'm gonna finish Auntie Sheba Pleaser for you, because we had another dialogue and she's yet to respond to me. This one says, okay. Okay, so this is exactly what I'm talking about here. Okay, it says the Rees Commission also indicated conclusively that the responsibility for the economic welfare of the American people had been transferred heavily to the executive branch of the federal government, that a corresponding change in education had taken place from the impetus outside the local community. That's the driving force of the community, okay, impetus. They love to use these big words. That this revolution had occurred, remember, you see the words they use, revolution, because that's what they're putting on you people. But there's different kinds of revolutions. Not all revolutions are bloody. All right? That this revolution had occurred without violence and with the full consent of an overwhelming majority of the electorate. You know they have those the electrical votes? This is what it is, electrically. I think I'm trying to say that. Mr. Dodd stated that this revolution could not have occurred peacefully or with the consent of the majority unless the education in the United States had been prepared in advance to endorse it. Now you see where you say democratic community. Reread that for you, let you understand. This is where this thing is coming from. According to Dewey, the profession of the classroom teacher is to produce the intelligence, skills, and character within each student so that the democratic community is composed of citizens who can think, do, and act intelligently and morally. All right? So this has nothing to do with educating people. This has to do with programming people for them to act and think and vote the way they want them to vote when they want to do what they want to do. You hear what it says, that this revolution had occurred without violence and with the full consent of an overwhelming majority of its electorate. Mr. Dodd stated that this revolution could not have occurred peacefully or with the consent of the majority unless education in the United States had been prepared in advance to endorse it. So what they mean prepared in advance? How do you prepare people in advance to endorse something? What form and tools and mechanisms, what formula are they using to have people to consent endorse things? You see how they have people to consent endorse homosexuality? They was already educating you in the educational process. I will never forget this. When I was in college, I ended up taking a class called Social Family. Because at the time, I wasn't in the truth yet. All I know is I thought I was going to get into social work because I wanted to help people. So I took this class called Social Family. And in the class, next thing you know, the professor, of course she's a lesbian, you know, and I wasn't comfortable with that already. Because because I don't want nobody that is lesbian or homosexual. I don't want nobody like that and that nature teaching me nothing. Okay, because I'm not in agreement with that lifestyle. I'm against it, and I'm not going to have nobody teaching me that is living that lifestyle. So anyways, at that time, I know I was going to get out of the class, but you know, the next thing, I had to write a paper. She wanted me to write a paper about two women who are both parents and what they, I mean, you know what, I couldn't even get into it. And I just resigned, withdraw from the class, okay, because that class had nothing to offer me. I have nothing to contribute to that kind of family structure. I know nothing of it. It's against my Father's heavenly will. So therefore, even though I wasn't in the truth, I still knew it was wrong. And it was against my beliefs. And I wasn't going to participate in it. So I got out of the class. You see, so if what I don't want for myself, I damn sure ain't going to do for my child. I don't give a damn about no job and no damn money. Because I hold my Father's values and his laws way more than any damn job. And my Father says you can't serve two masters. So I don't know what master she's serving when she continues to allow, when you, her and all of you all mothers and fathers, when you all continue to allow your children to go to a system that endorses these kinds of educational teachings in the academia, what they call academia world. I ain't getting the meaning of that. I should look to academia. It's probably something wicked too. Anyways, that's just one of them. So I'm gonna let y'all hear some of these. Okay, here's another one I'm gonna read again. Did I read this already? I think I did. I think I read this one for you already. Okay, I read all of these for you already. Okay, so, there's one more. I just want to make sure I get it all in here. So you all can see. Understand, what's the purpose of this educational system? All right, I think this is the same one I've already showed you. Okay, I've already communicated this to you already. So, let me move right on to finish communicating to you about Auntie Sheeple, Pleaser. So when she told me that, and this is what I responded to her and said, all right, well, then again, all I'm hearing is excuses. And I said, you don't seem to understand the evil you're living in. Are you serious right now? You see, that's when you try to do things in your own strength. I told you when there is a will, there's always a way. You keep telling me about a plan. The way the world is right now, there'll be no time to plan nothing. The time is only to act and to let the chips fall where they may. I have sent you extensive information showing you this evil devil education system is all about. And there's a big difference to indoctrinate and to educate. You don't seem to understand that this education system is not designed to educate. And maybe that's what you're suffering from yourself. And don't realize it. You're just as programmed when you keep thinking like these Europeans. They always have to have a plan in order to do something or act. But not always life will give you a plan. Sometimes you have to act based on the situation. You can't always plan when you know something is wrong. You have to act right now. You can't wait 2 months. You may not even have 2 months. You may not have 2 days. But anyways, I go on to tell her, that's why you are to trust and have faith, but you're not working with spirit. You're working in the physical. And she is, because, you know, I don't hear her speak nothing. I don't hear her speak anything spiritual in her videos. I don't know what are your spiritual beliefs, but you made it clear you don't associate yourself with the Hebrew Israelites. And again, you're able to take the time to educate and inform your subscribers, but you can't figure out how to protect your son and put his safety and well-being and take him out of a system which is only designed to brainwash and program, indoctrinate him into the society so he can be a good sheeple, like you say to your viewers. What it sounds like, you still need a babysitter for your children, and you have chosen to justify keeping them by saying it's 2 months left. Who knows if you will regret leaving them in if you don't, if you're taking so many chances, by taking so many chances with the treasures of your heart. She's yet to respond to that. Okay? Miss Auntie Sheba, please. All right, listen, you all. I want you all to hear this. And then I'm going to say some scriptures about for children. What Yahushua said, and talk a little bit about this. I want you all to listen to what's going on out there, what's already out there in your schools, what is spreading. You know, you all have to wake up and realize, get into, you all, it's like you're not dealing with reality here, you know? I mean, and some of you all, because you all been, went into that same, you have been conditioned and educated in the same damn system. So many of y'all still don't see it. And many of y'all probably don't realize you're still under the damn program and brainwashing and under this indoctrination. Because you all went through the same public education school system. I'm telling you, this is how they keep control over us as a people. And that's why they change us, because you know what? When instead of us keeping us enslaved, they have to find a way to control us. And what better other way than to do it than through the public school system? I already proved to you what the whole intent of it was. What the founder said, that the whole purpose of the design of it, he was the education reformer, the movement. Anyways, listen to this woman. I'm going to let you listen to her. It's called Perilous Times. Public school invites Satan into the classroom. Okay? I don't know how I got all the way over here. Let me. All right. Bear with me here. Oops. Now when I went back. Sorry. Let's go back one more time. Okay. Now, I did try uploading this internally, but it still was sounding, there was still like an echo on her voice. So the clearest that I can get it is recording it externally. All right, so of course, I'm just letting you hear the heart of the matter, and then I'm going to let you hear the last one, which is from the same anti-sheeple pleaser person, okay, that she can't figure out what to do with her own child. Okay, here goes. All right, you guys, bear with me now. All right.
Anyway, it's a whole other story. But what's going on in the classrooms? What happened to the public school system? It's been sold to Satan. That's what. I'm serious. Check this out. Check this out. I got the headline. It says here, district has invited Satan into the U.S. classroom. Say what? What do you mean? Oh no, we gotta read this, especially if your child goes to this particular classroom in Colorado. A school in Colorado is allowing satanic documents to be distributed to students. It says here that a school in Colorado has given atheist organizations the green light to distribute some satanic information to students in middle and high schools. You want to know how deceived people are? Because there's some deceived. It's some deception that's taking place in these last days. You have people going out of their way now saying, oh, Satanism isn't bad. Satanism is just illumination. I'm serious. It's that crazy. Are you covered by the blood of Jesus? Because unless you are, you may buy into that deception. Oh, he's not. Satanism isn't bad. The devil isn't bad. I was just illumination. I was just trying to, you just want to get illuminated. You want to do a little coloring book with a little kid sitting on a Baphomet. Is that it? It's sick. That's what's happening in these last days. Oh, kids, here's a crossword puzzle. Have you found the word Lucifer? Have you found the word sacrifice? Have you found the word Baal? Two A's now, two A's. It's crazy! Just homeschool. Just be safe and homeschool. But Evangelist, my kids won't be socially inept. It doesn't matter. What socialism, what, see, that's socialism, by the way. What social dysfunction do you think your kids will be into if they homeschool? What are they missing? Peer pressure? Peer pressure for them to be taking drugs? I mean, what social, what, for them to talk about sex and they're only in kindergarten? We don't want, listen, if you could just homeschool. Just homeschool. It's safe. It's all right. You have the right as parents. You want more information? Go to hsdla.org. I'm serious. That the Lord just blessed me with that organization. It's a Christian homeschooling legal organization that will hook you up with information as to how to homeschool your children. It doesn't matter what state or district you're in, and it doesn't even matter what nation you're in. They have a hookup worldwide. It's just awesome. Again, hsdla.org. Nobody tells me to do this. It's all being led by the Holy Spirit, and I praise God for that. I praise God for that. Because this ain't right. I got to read you the article. It says here, Delta County School District Assistant Superintendent Kirk Clay explained the following. Administrators don't want to be guilty of discrimination. Previously, the school district allowed for the distribution of free Bibles on campus grounds during course instructional time. Well, the Freedom From Religious Foundation, which is an atheist organization, the Western Colorado Atheist and Free Thinkers, along with the Satanic Temple, complained. They said that their groups ought to be allowed equal access. Really? The school cannot discriminate against various points of view, atheist Ann Longman told KVNF Radio. If it's going to distribute Christian literature, it also has to permit the distribution from every other point of view. Atheism, Satanism, Buddhism, they have to take all comers. This is an actual headline, my friends. This is how late the hour is. The stupidity of this Ann Landman, who's an atheist, says that if they're going to take one, they got to take them all. Really, Ann, says who? Says who? Because it ain't God that says that. It's your foolish flesh that says that. It's your rebellion. Your rebellion that says that. Is that satanic? It's the devil. Okay? It's that spirit that now continues to work in the sons of disobedience. And you're a son of disobedience, Ann Landman. If they're going to distribute Christian literature, they also have to permit the distribution from every other point of view. Says who? Do not be deceived. But see, the school got deceived. Why? Because God's been kicked out. Wherever God is kicked out, deception is welcomed. Wherever God has been kicked out, deception will immediately fill that void. Wherever God has been kicked out, the devil gets to rule. So check this out. You have this atheist by the name of Ann Landman who tells a radio station, school can't discriminate, they gotta allow every other point of view. So what does that school do? What does the school board of education do? Well, the actual superintendent, Kirk Clay, agreed. He agreed. So that tells me he's not even saved. He's not even right. He has no backbone. When someone agrees to satanic deception, it's because they don't have no backbone. If they don't have no backbone, it's because they don't have the Holy Ghost. If they don't have the Holy Ghost, it's because they're not born again. Goes on to say here, check this out. Breitbart reported on this. It says here, this is the other side of that story. The superintendent, the assistant superintendent said. He said, our policy says we cannot discriminate when it's handed out. We just have to follow the process. What idiots. On April 1st, this coming April, my friends, on April 1st, which is April Fool's Day. Ain't that it's April Fool's Day. Is it April Fool's Day on April 1st? Is it really? It's like a bad joke. Check this out. Let me double check. April 1st. Is it April Fool's Day? It's what's called April Fool's Day. All right. Now, we have 190 nations that tune in each week. Friends, my international friends, we here in America actually hold observance to a day called April Fool's Day, right? Ain't that stupid? That's how foolish things have become here in the U.S. Apparently on April 1st, April Fool's Day, students of the district's middle and high schools will now have access to brochures with titles such as The Top 10 Public School Church Violations and How to Stop Them, or The Satanic Children's Big Book of Activities, and What's Wrong with the Ten Commandments. The only exceptions are that the publications cannot promote illegal behavior, such as drug use, pornography, violence, or advertised products for sale. The Delta School District said it was considering a change in policy. Land, the atheist woman, she points out no material is allowed to be handed out, only made available. Early last year, Orange County Schools in Florida, and we reported on this last year, by the way, the Orange County Schools in Florida ditched plans to hand out Bibles after atheist groups threatened to respond by handing out satanic literature. Rebecca, how telling that satanic literature will be now handed out in U.S. classrooms starting on April 1st, Fool's Day. God says only a fool in heart says that there is no God. That's what the book of Proverbs says. Only a fool says in their heart there is no God. So of course, pass it out on April Fool's Day.
Okay. I hope you all was able to take in a good bit of what she said. And of course, like she said, she agrees with me. Homeschooling is by far the best option for many of you all. Stop focusing on your jobs. You all have to put your children first. You have to find a way to rearrange your lives. Stop putting these jobs and your money and your children's well-being and this mental damage that is being done to your kids. That's why you all yourselves are not really in the right place you should be. But anyways, like I said, if after anyone who listens to this segment and you know somebody that has children that goes to this educational system, you all understand now what this system is intending for. What is the purpose that it was created for? It is not created to educate your children. Now I want you all to listen to Anti-Sheeple Pleaser. It's called, the title of it, Parents Outraged by Transgender Reveal in Kindergarten, okay? Now, this is her presenting truth for the mass, her subscribers. All right, hold on. Bear with me, guys.
Truly pissed off.
I'm sorry, I want you to hear from the beginning. There you go.
Good morning, Anti-Sheeple Pleaser family. This is MB Anti-Sheeple Pleaser. I am back once again. So it looks like you have some parents that are truly pissed off and outraged by a transgender reveal in a kindergarten class, no less. Of all places, kindergarten. Kindergarten. Okay, this is where they are, you know, learning shapes and names and ABC and 1, 2, 3, and what the hell do they know about, okay, now, let me go ahead and read the article. This occurred in Rockland, California, by the way. It says the Rockland Academy School Board is facing tough questions from parents concerned over a controversial incident involving transgender discussions inside a kindergarten class. CBS Sacramento reports these parents feel betrayed by the school district that they were not notified, said Karen England with the Capital Resource Institute. The incident happened earlier this summer during the last few days of the academic school year. At Monday night's board meeting, the teacher at the center of the controversy spoke out. With emotions high, she addressed a packed house. I'm so proud of my students. It was never my intent to harm any students, but to help them through a difficult situation, she said. The teacher defended her actions to read 2 children's books about transgenderism, including one titled I Am Jazz. She says the books were given to her by a transgender child going through a transition. The kindergartens came home very confused about whether or not you can pick your gender, whether or not they really were a boy or a girl, said England. Parents say besides the books, the transgender student at some point during class also exchanged clothes and was revealed as her true gender. And many parents say they feel betrayed and blindsided. I want her to hear from me as a parent, what her gender identity means to her and our family, not from a book that may be controversial, a parent said. My daughter came home crying and shaking, so afraid she could turn into a boy, another parent said. The issue was not on the agenda, so parents spoke out during public comment. It's really about the parents being informed and involved and giving us the choice and rights of what's being introduced to our kids and at what age, said parent Chelsea McQuiston. Many teachers also spoke out in support of what transpired inside the classroom. They spoke about the importance of teaching students about diversity and having healthy dialogues. This is not a healthy dialogue for a five-year-old. It is not. I mean, for crying out loud, they don't even understand what is going on in the classroom yet. As you hear, you had some parents, little girls, coming home crying about thinking that they were going to turn into boys. What makes you think that this is a healthy dialogue for kindergarten class? I need to understand that part. I really do. It goes on to say, one parent said the impact on her son was extremely positive. It was so precious to see that he had absolutely no prejudice in his body. My child just went in there and listened to the story and didn't relate it to anything malicious or didn't question his own body, she said. When we heed in the direction of banned books, our book list, our selected literature, that should only be read inside or outside the classroom. I think that's a very dangerous direction to go, said seventh grade teacher Kelly Bryson. The district says the books were age appropriate and fell within their literature selection policy. Unlike sex education, the topics of gender identity don't require prior parental notice. In a statement during the board meeting, the district said, as indicated by Superintendent Robin Stout in a communication last week, staff will be engaging parents and teachers in discussions about how materials outside our curriculum will be addressed in the future. The large discussion has compelled the board to put the item on the next month's agenda. I myself feel it is inappropriate. Props to the parents that came out in order to question that, because it should have been questioned. I definitely would have questioned it myself if my child would ever come home and say that, you know, Mom, we talked about this in class, you know, in elementary school. I think that's inappropriate. I can understand having that education in high school. I can get that for maybe even the latter years of middle school, but in elementary school, in kindergarten no less, in kindergarten, they haven't even made it the first grade yet. Do you see how young they are getting these children with this? Okay, I'm going to go on to another story. It says a baby born in Canada is the first child without a gender designation on their health card. And I'm trying to understand this as well. When a child is first being born, okay, as they grow up in life, life is difficult. Why make it more difficult by not even giving them a gender? I'm trying to understand the mindset of a parent that would do this. And I mean, I understand being open and liberal and all of that good stuff, you know, all of that. But what about common sense? Where did that go in the equation? Can we have a class on common sense, please? Anyhow, let me go ahead and read the story. It says, peanut butter, Anne of Green Gables, and Ryan Reynolds have topped our list of favorite things from Canada for ages. Now they're embracing this parent fighting to let their child choose their own gender. Corey Dottie identifies as a gender non-binary person and is making their mark on history by opting to raise their child outside of the gender binary. Dottie gave birth to Cyril Atley last November and has since proven themselves a parent to be reckoned with by campaigning to give their baby a genderless start and a life without labels. Since giving birth to their baby in November, Dottie has not assigned their baby a gender. According to CBC News Network, Dottie fought hard to have their child receive a health card marked with a U under gender, which stands for undetermined or unassigned. While the government has so far refused to give the baby a certificate without a gender assignment, the health card is already proven to be a huge victory. Cyril is the first known baby to not be assigned a gender at birth. Dottie is advocating on their baby's behalf to choose their own gender because of the negative effects Dottie experienced being assigned the wrong gender at their own birth. When I was born, doctors looked at my genitals and made assumptions about who I would be. And those assignments followed me and followed my identification throughout my life, Batty told CBC News. Those assumptions were incorrect, and I ended up having to do a lot of adjustment since then. Batty recently shared that it has been like to raise a non-binary child on YouTube. Batty's efforts to ensure their child has every opportunity in their life to freely express their identity is major snacks of approval on our end. Well, not on mine. I just feel like, you know, the world is changing at a crazy rate, and probably things that we consider to be strange today may be absolutely normal 10 years from now. But me, I'm kind of old school, and to me, this really makes little to no sense. Maybe because I haven't walked in this person's shoes or whatever happened to understand exactly what that lifestyle is like. But, I mean, could you imagine how difficult it might be for the baby by not assigning this child a gender? You know, that's the thing about it. That sometimes parents only want to see things from their point of view. And I think that might be the situation here. I mean, but hey, if it works out for them, then it works out for them. But I'm just giving my opinion. I think that, you know, the world is just going real far. Things are being taken to an extreme with this stuff that's going on now as far as gender assignments and things of that nature. But anyway, I'm out. To each his own. And please, don't forget, click the donation button. It should be popping up in your top left-hand corner. Click that. Go ahead and become a Patreon.
Okay, I'm going to stop right there. We don't need to go into all of her donation buttons. I think that's the whole problem with this woman. So she's, there's a couple of things that I'm going to point out that she said that tells you that she's affected by this system and the ideologies of this system. First of all, she has an issue with them teaching this type of ideology and this idea and ideology to kindergartners, okay? But maybe she could understand if it's being taught in high school and middle school. How the hell are you going to even understand that? How can you even understand that being taught at all, whatsoever? So that tells you where her mind is and how much she's able to comprehend and what she's taking in and how much they're conditioning her. Because they have already conditioned her enough for her to say she can understand it being taught when you are in high school or middle school. You can't understand it being taught in when they're in kindergarten, but you can understand it being taught when they're in middle school and high school. It makes no sense to me. She's talking about there's no common sense. She don't got no sense at all, period. You know, and she may not appreciate what I'm saying, but I'm just keeping it real. How the hell can you even attempt to say that, you know, maybe you could understand that being taught in high school and middle school? Why would you even want that something to be taught like that at all, period? That has no purpose. What is the purpose for that being taught? For who and for what? You know, and because people like her, they can push this on her. Because she's not even strong enough to make the decision to take her child out of the same school. Now she's giving the information to her 23,000 plus subscribers, right? But the same information, she can't take the common sense. She claims ain't no common sense, but she ain't got none at all, period, herself. Because she can't make an ethical, moral decision. Moral and spiritual decision. I don't even know what spiritual foundation Auntie Sheba Pleaser Mitchell have. Because I've never heard her talk about the Most High or whatever, you know. And if she doesn't figure out, stop talking about him, she's going to be in a lot of problems. But she still thinks this world going as normal, you know, and things are going to have certain things are going to be accessible to her. She don't know that martial law, and I think she knows about all of these things that are going to take place. Either she thinks that it ain't going to happen, or, you know, it's not going to affect her. I don't know. Okay, so what the hell you care about what they teaching in high school or middle school that is, and you're giving a consent that it's okay for them to teach that shit at all? And then she goes, why are we trying to understand? And that's what I said. This proves she herself is already programmed to accept this. I just said she's a mess. You know, and then she said, she's not going to be concerned about this shit. That she said that she made a comment and said that it might be normal 10 years from now. What the hell? How can transgender ever be normal 10 years from now? What in your mind? I would ask this woman that you will even say that something like that could be normal 10 years from now. I mean, you would even utter something like that out of your mouth. Do you want something like that to be normal 10 years from now? What kind of ramifications would that have in your life and your children's life? Do you not think that these things are not going to come up to your door? This is the problem with you people, you so-called people who say you all know truth. See, the problem with this anti-sheeple pleaser Mitchell, she's only focusing on and giving truth for monetary reasons, because she's looking for donations, and that's what she's doing it for. So, and the actuality is really not about, you know, I mean, fine, she's giving out information, but she's not really doing nothing. She's not applying nothing that she's given. Her own damn self, you know, because I don't understand how as a parent you're able to identify all of these things that clearly it is not ethical, morally, or spiritually right for any child or any children to be being taught. I mean, this is a whole new ball game here, you know what I'm saying? I mean, we need to have parents in an outrage of what they want to teach your children now. What they want to make acceptable to your children. You see? And you all just let it happen. You all consent to it. The devil have to have you to consent to something like this. And this is how they get you to consent. By teaching you, call, and making you believe and justifying it. Sneaking it up through the educational process system. Into the academia world. Because when you start teaching people about a way of life, eventually what happens is they accept it to be as normal. Just like this anti-sheeple pleaser woman, when she says she can understand them teaching it to them when they're in middle school and high school, but not kindergarten. What the hell difference does it make? It shouldn't be taught at all. But anyways, I'm just saying, it's just terrible, you know, that this is, I hope that, I'm going to send her this segment. Now, whether she listens to the whole of it, I don't know. But this woman needs... she needs to find some kind of spiritual enlightenment so she can wake up to more of the truth that she keeps, that she's hiding from or running from or not acknowledging, or she just can't see. Okay? Because if she thinks she knows all of the truth out there, I told her the rabbit hole goes way deeper. We've just begun to unlayer layers here. There's lots of layers. The hole goes deep. And it just seems to be getting deeper and deeper. You know, because I can't say I know. I mean, even as much as I believe I'm understanding it, I mean, what I'm more sound and grounded in, you know, is a spiritual understanding. You know, when you understand, when you're going through, when your eyes are open spiritually, your ears are open spiritually, you can hear and see the things that are going in this world spiritually. Because we do have a spiritual world that you all have not been conditioned or been inclimated into. Because, you know, this world have indoctrinated you completely away from that. And that's why you all think and act and respond to these things the way you all do. Like anti-sheeple pleaser, because that's what her son's going to be. As long as she keep him in that, as long as you all keep your children in these public school systems, they're going to be sheeple. That's what her sign on her channel's name is. Anti-sheeple pleaser Mitchell. She pleasing the sheeple. But little to know, she's a sheeple her damn self. Because she can't figure out herself to disassociate herself long enough to put her son first place, get him out of the system, because it ain't doing him no damn good. I got another person that I know that does the same, didn't want to take his son out because his wife can't handle taking care of him and supposedly, you know, you have a child dealing with what they call, attention deficit order. I'm sorry. it's a something that that they can't keep still. I forgot the terminology, the term for it that they have right now, which most of these young black boys have from that damn medication that hasn't been given him. And the vaccinations is what caused a lot of these problems in these children. So that's why you shouldn't give your children none of these vaccinations. You see what I'm saying? So, you know, I don't understand. You know, now they're going to have teachers that are going to be armed in school. They're going to allow teachers to be armed in school. All these teachers need to say now is that you or the student threaten their lives. Just like these damn wicked-ass cops out here. And now they're going to be killing our black children in schools now. You know what? Woe to you, mothers and fathers. Woe unto you, mothers and fathers out there. That you all just send your children into the devil's den every morning for them to just totally destroy your children morally, ethically, and spiritually. And you all are going to have to answer for that. You're going to have to account for it. Because this is what these segments are about. It's about informing you to make you aware of what this system is about and what it really is. And what's the purpose of it. And once you know, you need to act. And stop sitting your ass and pretending like it doesn't affect you. It ain't affecting you, but it's affecting your child. All because you want to save a few dollars. And them same few dollars you trying to save ain't going to mean shit in a minute. Because that dollar's about to hit the ground. You need to put your children first. None of you all put your children first anymore. You put your damn jobs before your head of your children. That's why these children are getting lost. And the devil is easy to eat them up and take them away. These social services are all designed to do that. And you all help them too by giving your children into these social services hands, by them learning the things that they're being taught in these wicked evil system called a school, public educational. But anyways, I want to go over some scriptures, and I just hope that you mothers and fathers stop using this system to babysit your children. To justify that you have to hold on to your job. You ain't got nobody to take care of your kid. You need to think about your children first. Put your children first. The Most High said he will provide for you all. That's how scared and programmed you all are in the system. You let this system dictate every part and aspect of your lives. All the way down to your children. They control everything about you. And that's just the way they want you to be. But anyways, this is for the children. Matthew 19 and 13. And then the children were brought to him that he might lay his hands on them and pray. The disciple rebuked the people. But Yahushua said, let the children come to me and do not hinder them. For to such belong the kingdom of heaven. And he laid his hands on them and they went away. All right? And this is, again, I want to say, do not harm the children. For those the children, those who are harmed, that harm children. You know something? Somebody had a dream, because a lot of people are having dreams and visions. They said that when they went, they sell no children in hell. That's a beautiful thing. That's a blessing. All praises unto the Most High. This is Mark chapter 9, verse 42. Whoever calls one of these little ones who believes in me to sin, it would be better for him if a great milestone were hung around his neck and he were thrown in the sea. So for those of you who hurt children, who are innocent, and even have some kind of idea of the Most High, and they believe in God, and if you hurt them, you are going to suffer treacherously. Treacherously. Oh yeah, make no mistake. That's going to happen. Proverbs 22:6. Train up a child in the way he should go, and he, when he is old, he will not depart from it. Many of you all do not raise your children under these doctrine. And these are what you call sound doctrines. You see? Because the system is certainly not training up a child in the way it should go. They're training up a child in the lifestyle these children, they want these children to engage in. Okay? Because they've hired anal sex experts in the educational system. I want you all to be aware of that. Okay? You know where it's going. It's already there. Chapter 14, 15. The simple believes everything, but the prudent looks to where he is going. All right? You simple people, you believe everything. But those of you who are prudent, you take the time to see where you're going. All right? 14:33. Wisdom abides in the mind of a man of understanding, but it is not known in the hearts of fools. All right? So those of you all who claim you have wisdom and you have knowledge, but you have no understanding, you don't have anything, because you, it's known you all have a heart of a fool. All right? Chapter 15, verse 10. There is severe discipline for him who forsakes the way. He who hates reproof will die. And most of them young men out there, they're dying because they don't like to be talked to. They all don't like nobody to tell you all nothing. You know, you can't talk to these younger people now these days. They know everything. But then they're dying like flies. Shiloh and Abaddon lie open before Yahuwah. How much more the hearts of men? So Shiloh, for those of you who do not know what Shiloh means, that means hell. And Abaddon is another name for that devil. So with where Shiloh is. The mind of him who has understanding seeks knowledge, but the mouths of fools feed on folly. Okay? A wise son makes a glad father, but a foolish man despises his mother. He who ignores instructions despises himself, but he who heeds admonition gains understanding. Do any of you all despise any kind of instructions? I'm just let you know. You despise yourself. The fear of Yahuwah is instructions in wisdom, and humility goes before honor. Right? The wise of heart is called a man of discernment. A stupid son is a grief to a father, and the father of a fool has no joy. A foolish son is grief to his father and bitterness to her who bore him. And many of you all got to understand, because some of these kids out here, they're outrageous. They really are. And I know they make their parents look bad, and I know they feel in shame. A fool takes no pleasure in understanding, but only in expressing his opinion. Many of you all know how to talk. You know how to run your mouth. You don't. That's all you all do. You express your opinion, but none of you all take pleasure in understanding or listening. Proverbs chapter 18, verse 2. Proverbs 13, chapter 2, verse 24. He who spares the rod hates his son, but he who loves him is diligent to discipline him. So if you hate your children when you don't discipline them, none of you will love your children, because none of you will really take the time to discipline them. You say he who spares the rod hates his son. The rod and reproof gives wisdom, but a child left to himself brings shame to his mother. And those of you all, leave your children alone by yourself. Many times, people, you ought to understand. I know many of you all do. But some of these wicked mothers who hot in the ass, as I was called them, they would leave their children alone, small little children, or leave one might be about 8, not old enough to take care of the 2 or 3 year old, but they would leave the 8 year old to take care of the small ones while he or she go out doing whatever. You know, some of them might be looking for drugs, looking for sex, who knows? You see, those mothers are in hell. That their destination is hell. Okay, that leaves those children by themselves. You see that? The rod reproves and gives wisdom, but a child left to himself brings shame to his mother. All right? all I know is I still have this segment. I'm going to do another segment. I got to bring in this transhumanism for you all so you can hear what these Frankenstein scientists are working in your labs, they probably already got it, knowing these devils. They got it already. I hope you all place take heed to understand that every time you send your school on that little yellow black bus, you're sending your children to be indoctrinated so they can be good slaves, so they can be obedient unto the massive, the powers to be. Okay? I'm just going to ask you all to pause 1 second. Okay, so I hope that I've given you guys ample information here about this educational system, the purpose, the design, the intent for it. Okay, these are the principles and the foundations of the academic educational system that you people send your children to. The system is designed away from the Most High in excluding Him. They do not believe this human manifesto that these originated founders that have set up the foundation for this public school system, which is ongoing to this day. They do not believe in the Most High. That's why they made sure to eventually eliminate the praying you cannot have. Though they teach you about all kinds of various religions and all kinds of cultures, you know, more things that they need to be teaching you, they don't teach you about what is right morally and ethically and spiritually right. That's the foundation they refuse to include in that curriculum. But yet they are going to include transgender, homosexual, and all of these other things that is not according to your spiritual beliefs, but yet you send your children to a system that promotes, encourages, and teaching it to your child. So, you know, you all are going to answer for these things. You really are. Okay, so this is a soul to have you all, that you know it's time for you to really take a strong, firm re-examination of what your children are being taught and if it's really worth it. Okay, you need to be focusing your children on the Bible and the structure and the commandments and the statutes of what the Father has in there that have more beneficial for them than this devil education. Okay, as they say, a chapter a day keeps the devil away.
Let's fire up, please.
The words of His Majesty I done proclaim. Behold the Emperor, yeah. The world is perfect, perfection is the key to life. Behold the Emperor, John, your works are beautiful, but only it's judgment. It's its own separation, I tell you. King of kings and Lord of lords, rise every day, rise and take your people away. Move to the feeling of people movement, black people. After fear, a chapter a day keeps the devil away. Behold the Emperor, the words of my majesty is lumped to my back. Keep me away from wrath, oh yeah. Jamais de sin jamais de sin jamais de
leader rising, rise and shine every day. Ja 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 ja
ja
ja ja ja ja
ja
ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja ja